Nat, where you left off in the first Homeward Bound, I just was traveling to find this cave on the map. This was the outpost that we created, as you well remember. And then I went a little bit beyond here and just found a cave, because this is where one of the memories is, so I'm heading towards the memory. And this has some weird cat that I just killed in the cave. And a cool little design here, so we'll see what this is about. Whoa, shit! Whoa. Shit. That was deadly as shit. How do I heal this? Unbelievably dangerous. I'll die right when I get out there. Life support deleted. Right above me. This is not gonna work. Come on.
Whoa. The cat built all this? They don't just have a base here. This is a stronghold.
My life support is gonna die any second. It's over here. How am I not dead? Let's... No! No!
Bane, we're coming up on the barracks.
Stay sharp.
God.
There shouldn't be as many here as the base. No reason to get cocky, though.
Doc, got it.
Duh. We've got targets!
They're not keeping it.
We need an up-close scan.
Detecting above normal radiation levels.
Son of a bitch. Alright, we're gonna have to return to here at a later date when I get better equipment with this crazy radiation. These rads, man. Ah, it's better.
Radiation within safe levels.
Yeah, let's,
Ugh.
Recording Initiative Cryo Identification E-97 Durango. Chief Engineer Grace Leto.
Last one out during the evac.
She took risks and they didn't work. But nothing worked.
Gave it everything she could. Maybe that's all you can do.
Well, I broadcast just in case. Now this is pretty worth this back and forth trying to figure this stuff out. So this kind of stuff you could skip through, but
life support restored.
Just know that I just broadcast no matter what, just to play it safe, you know. I don't want you to miss anything. Just in case something crazy happens. But I think we're good now. So let's get off this rock. We can come back to get that memory later once I get better armor. Alright. Whew. Yep.
Ascent is go.
Leaving Atmel. All clear.
Okie dokie. Gotta talk to Addison, Tan, confirm the murder. See if anything good happens. I sure hope so. I have stats in an hour.
Before the meeting gets started, I have bunk assignments for PB and Drac.
Already put my rucksack in the kitchen. I'll hang out there if that's okay.
And I'm in one of the escape pods. More my speed. That's fantastic. Welcome aboard. Any thoughts, Ryder?
We're adventurers. Whatever makes the squad comfortable is okay with me. Let's talk about our success on Eos. Besides establishing our first viable outpost, we did some amazing things. We discovered the Remnant and breached their vault.
And didn't get killed.
Overcame radiation poisoning a number of times.
And didn't die.
Confronted by Ket at every turn.
Once again, did not get killed.
You guys really need to raise the bar on what you call success.
Yeah, should we use the Krogan definition of success that got your homeworld nuked by your own people?
Whoa!
Fair enough.
Let's focus.
But also true.
Back to the task at hand. Looking forward.
Exactly. Here's my only question. When do we hit that next vault? It looked active. We have to get on that.
Hang on, hang on. We need to not go off half-cocked.
There are initiative priorities. The team calls the shots.
Actually, the Pathfinder calls the shots, just to be clear.
Awkward.
So what do you need from us, Ryder?
Just get along, you bunch of kids.
Let's be kind and give each other the benefit of the doubt. Finding a home for tens of thousands in this hellscape is stressful enough without adding dysfunction.
You got it, boss.
If Krogan are known for one thing, it's getting along.
But not humility or self-awareness.
Okay, let's head back to the Nexus. PB, Drac, see Lexi for a physical. Good meeting, everyone.
Just be nice is not what I wanted to say.
Strike team,
when you've
ready
got
for deployment.
A minute, stop by the med bay.
You got it. I don't know where I am. Strike team missions. Research center or something. Is it buy or sell kiosk? Biolab.
Nice place you found.
Clean air, plants, helps me think.
Something on your mind?
Maybe.
Your biotics always do that when you're maybe stressed?
I got it. I'm good. I don't normally lose it like that. A Huntress should have better control.
Huntress?
Another term for an Asari commando. I was one before the initiative. Some things stick, though. Like losing the old man.
There's a lot of loss going around. Dad? The Golden Worlds?
A friend and mentor who trained you to be a Pathfinder. I prepped for years as your father's second. Then he chooses you? An untrained Pathfinder and all this mess to fix?
Hey.
What the hell was he thinking?
Hey.
Is this going to be a problem, Cora?
I don't want a rival. Just answers. It's done. Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive. Then maybe we'll all get what we came out here for.
Jesus.
So what brought you out to Andromeda?
Biotics like this. Thinking like an Asari huntress. I never had a place. Best I could be was a useful freak. The initiative was meant to be different. Will be different if this mission succeeds. So I'm seeing it through. It's quiet in here. I can keep the plants watered while I work. First job, see if there's any news on the Asari Ark. If they made it, we could use some Asari expertise.
Damn straight.
If you want to talk, I'll be here.
Just seem a little bit biotype. Let's see what you're still doing. Okay. Still calibrating?
Hi there.
Hey!
What did you do while you were part of the Asari military?
4 years in a commando unit called Talane's Daughters.
That's awesome.
Part of the Council's cross-species military integration initiative. You probably had a more exciting time defending that Arcturus relay. But we did good work. Peacekeeping is a full-time job, even in Asari space.
What was your commando unit like?
Janae and I were the youngsters. Tethys was our old lady sniper. Kalia patched us up, and Valenza prayed between firefights. Our CO, Nasira, led us all over the Athena Nebula and beyond. A Huntress's work is never done.
Who'd pick a fight with the most powerful species in the galaxy?
Themselves, usually. Terrorists, cults, rogue Ardat Yakshi, people demanding a withdrawal from the Citadel. The Asari were spacefaring when our Roman Empire was new. Didn't fix all their problems. Sometimes you need commandos for that.
You were in the Alliance before you became a Huntress, right? What made you join up?
My biotics. I was still living on my parents' cargo freighter when they manifested. Untrained biotic power on a starship means accidents. But we couldn't afford a tutor. The Alliance had implants, the training, everything. Old history now. Your turn. Remind me why you came to Andromeda.
I spent years watching pioneers go through the Arcturus mass relays. Off to glory, while I stayed behind. Then Dad's career collapsed. His AI research made him too toxic.
I heard. Must have changed everything for your family.
We needed to start over somewhere new together. Or as together as we could. So, Andromeda.
None of you writers ever think small, do you?
Did you come out here with anyone? Maybe someone you served with?
I had my fun on shore leave. Nothing serious, though. Asari Huntress's figure things out, but I was there for soldiering, not romance.
Does that mean fraternization is okay for Asari Commandos?
It'll happen, but usually only for one deployment. Asari don't usually stay with each other long term. After your 500th birthday, you learn some self-control.
After 4 years with Asari Commandos, you must have some great war stories.
Nasira assassinated a Krogan warlord with a pack of playing cards once.
A pack of cards?
Choking hazard, apparently.
Wow. How's the search for the Asari Ark going?
The Lucinia? Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
Thank you, BioWare, for always making cool characters. But she kind of scares me and makes me angry, so I'm not gonna romance her. Already checked there. Let's check here. Wait, right? Yeah, okay. Sh-da-dee-dee-dee. Where's my...
We haven't spoken since orientation, have we?
It's all been so hectic, but I'm sure things will quiet down soon. Can't be worse than the Nexus.
Word.
Whoa!
Hello, Ryder. Forgive the intrusion. I have an issue that you and Sam should be able to relatively solve. You may assist my investigation into the scourge. We can discuss it in person. Cool. Word, that reminded me of that shit too. That's just the Asari homeworld map if you can't remember. But you, of course you do, because you're a bro. Hey. Huh? Oh my god, it's hilarious. Oh. Oh, it's hilarious. Now that's up your alley, huh? You got to try these. Challenge accepted, Nally. All right, cool. I'm feeling a little bit better about the game. Hey!
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
A little Irish? Much? You know, I'm gonna say it looks dangerous. Nah, it doesn't.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
Oh, here we go. A god?
You mean a god?
Yes. I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd, but I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
I actually kind of like that. Hello! Let me check. Hello, sorry for the long pause. Get a calculator from my friend. Okay.
There's something about coming face to face with something wondrous that makes you want to believe.
Wow. It's wonderful to meet someone who understands. I've had to justify myself so often.
You didn't really clarify.
As if having faith in the divine invalidated my work as a scientist. As if this sacred
diminished with the search for truth. I think it all
works together.
Damn straight.
I wasn't questioning your abilities. You never have to justify yourself to me.
Thank you. I appreciate you saying that, truly. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
Yeah, sure. Alright, you're the pilot.
Glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector.
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
You mentioned something about helping design the Tempest?
Test pilot, mostly. Plunging through the Nemean Abyss was almost a preparation for the Scourge. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
I get it. Like leaving a good story half finished.
The team liked that one of us was going. It felt right after all we went through. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console, 3 drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
Son of a bitch.
Did you hear anything about the arc back in the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Solarians.
Cheer up, Callow. We'll always have Director Tan.
That snide little bureaucrat? All the more reason to find the others. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
Thanks, dude. I was being sarcastic about Tan, hope I can.
What can I do for you?
Oh, yeah.
If you helped to build the Tempest, you must know plenty about her.
Just about everything. By memory, it was quite the effort to get her working. The initiative needed absolutely up-to-date technology, which we all had to coordinate, and some of it was rather tricky to acquire.
Acquire?
Buy, legally and above board, of course. Yes. Sadly, the other Pathfinder vessels were lost when the Scourge hit the Nexus. The Tempest is truly unique.
You know, I haven't actually met many Salarians.
Careful. Depending who you ask, we're conniving spies, genius researchers, or meddling scientists. We have to pack a lot of living into 40-odd years. Everything gets accelerated. Lines blur. I just hope we don't repeat our old mistakes out here.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Well, I can't talk about Suvi. She's sitting right there.
I'm not listening. You can say whatever you like.
Oh no, I'm not falling for that again.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
See if you have anything extra to say to Suvi.
I saw pictures of the vault. Astounding how big it is. And how much of it didn't you see? What if it's way bigger? What's all that space for?
Wild remnant parties. What else would you use it for?
Well, that's a thought. You don't really think they... Oh, joking. I see. Good one.
I take it you work closely with the Nexus Science team?
I try to keep in contact with them. We discuss anything and everything we discover out here. After all, many brains are better than one, and Dr. Aridana is worth two or three at least. I work best when I have other people to bounce ideas off of.
I'm still fuzzy about how we managed to see Andromeda all the way from home.
It confused me too. I mean, the light lag would have made any data 2 million years out of date. So I asked Dr. Aridana, and she told me, well, it wasn't her tech that did it. It was the Geths.
You're kidding. Those killer robots we had in the Milky Way?
Those exact ones. The Initiative obtained data from an array in deep space. A Geth construct. According to Aridana, the Geth rebuilt a mass relay and turned the approach corridor into an FTL sensor.
Geniuses.
It operated like a telescope, just faster than light. It provided much more up-to-date info. We don't know why the Geth were interested in observing beyond the galaxy, though. Maybe we'll never know.
Did my dad know about this? Why didn't he tell me?
It's possible he didn't know. The Geth are isolationist and hostile. Using the info, even obtaining it in the first place, probably crossed a lot of boundaries.
That's awesome.
What do you know about the Remnant's terraforming network?
From what I can tell, the vault is designed to adjust almost everything about a planet. Climate, pH of the soil, atmosphere composition. There's even evidence that it can propagate life. If we can figure out how to control the vaults, we could turn these worlds into perfect habitats.
When did you start believing in a god?
My parents were both scientists. My home was ruled by rationality. So when I became a teenager, let's just say that while other kids found Batarian music, I found God.
But your work as a scientist...
convinced me even more, especially when I got into molecular biology, physics. The patterns I kept seeing over and over again, they were like an artist's watermarks. God, to me, is an artist. An inventor, not someone checking to see if I brush my teeth.
She hasn't used tea yet.
What do you know about the Scourge?
We established that it's artificial. Someone put it there. Or they did something that caused its creation.
Peter's fire.
We don't know why. That's still a mystery.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.
I like talking to people. Keep it up. Oh. Hey. Shower or something? Hey, weird loadout station. Like,
you're setting up in here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault.
They're life pods.
If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Does your brain ever take a breath?
Sorry, not really. Even my dreams are in time lapse. I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that. Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field, while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
Yeah.
Tackling complete strangers in the Milky Way wasn't doing it for you?
I think tackling you anywhere would be fun. Did I say that out loud?
Whoa.
Life won't be boring with you around. I may never yawn again.
Whoa. BioWare's unrealistic escalates are great.
You left everything and everyone you knew because you were bored?
No. I came with someone I knew. Then she got bored with me. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
Well, congratulate yourself. No one has ever so successfully dodged my attempts to get to know them.
Yes! I'm number one! Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth. Then again... I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned. Which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
I think she was flirting again there. Clayco. Hey! What's up?
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
Yep.
You really won't tell me what you're working on.
That's right. Next question.
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Well, I wasn't supposed to be woken up yet. A resourceful accomplice finagled my early thaw. So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin, I started, borrowing shuttles. After that, I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
Let's do this!
What does someone have to do to get you to flirt with them?
Not much at all. But I get a little extra jolt when I'm matched wink for wink. So, just be yourself, and the flirts will flow.
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone?
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. The one who woke me up early. But now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
So how do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Vetra. Not your typical military-minded Turian. Liam seems a lively one. I expect he'll surprise me. Drek is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
What about...
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Callo and Suvi seem busy. I hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right. Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
She's exactly what she should be. Capable, reliable. She's a valuable part of my team.
Sure, sure. That comes across too.
There's also Lexi, our doctor. She's in Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
What drew you to the Remnant?
Are you kidding? It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that. There's so much to discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech, it's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
You're off the hook, PB. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
Yep. Guys. Oh, we got a bridge. Aha, I need to load. Yeah? Let's see if I can find my damn crew.
Talking to
Kesh, Nexus superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
Someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tam. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Leaving the Nexus can't have been an easy choice.
It was, actually. Staying became impossible. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tam's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Rushan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to. As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue with that.
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for Kesh ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself. Damn proud of her, too. She did good. Even with me for a granddad.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Did Lexi brief you on SAM and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comm, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah. I was dismissed from the Alliance when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
Almost. I'm not thrilled about it myself, but it is what it is.
Just make sure it can't unshackle itself. There'll be hell to pay if that happens.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
Yo, what's up, YouTube? We got Ben Spanner here. Hey, welcome to the stream, everybody. This is Ben Spanner here. I was just talking to my Krogan friend, but we're going to take a short break and talk to Ben Spanner for a moment. Ben Spanner, how you doing? That's right, everyone. Today is Monday, and that's as much news as we can provide. And we'll be back here on Fox News, everyone. The news today is it's Monday, and back to you, Jack. Hey, Jack says. Jack, it's actually Tuesday. Shit. Hey, hi, welcome, everyone. It's Tuesday. Yeah. Oh. dude, how's it going? Nice, dude. I'm talking to a Krogan. Hey, the Krogans look pretty damn good in this game. No, I actually haven't been many. It's actually funny because like that image you sent me of that woman. She is like the epitome of the awful facial animations, but they're all really not that bad. But she's like the worst, and I don't know why she's so bad. It's like everyone looks pretty good, but she looks so bad all the time you talk to her. Like they really goofed or something with her. Yeah, she's like one of the main. You like talk to her a lot too. So it gets really creepy. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. No, but the other stuff looks good. I am finally getting to know my crew, which is really good. And I'm really liking. I just debated with my pilot about God. It was really fun. Yeah, but cool. It's pretty cool. Good old Mass Effect politics and all that stuff. It's all going well. I talk this guy.
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus.
Word.
She swiped supplies I was trying to get for cash right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
I like some of these characters, though. They're all kind of turning the stereotypes of a lot of races on their head, which is really fun. Like, yeah, it's really cool. Like, you have a scavenger thief Turian. And you have, you know, like a crazy rebel, free spirit, Asari. you meet this Krogan who is older than Sin. Like, he's just an old man. Yeah. It's pretty good. Pretty good.
She really has a way of getting things done.
She sure does. But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Kesh's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Kesh all along. They're both still laughing at me over there.
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
My clan's there. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable. The works. Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
Food's food. Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps. I'm pretty fond of Korkrow roots myself.
Hey, this guy's a farmer. He's a Krogan farmer.
So about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some details.
Ha! The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have.
Nice.
I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years. Don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck. And a really hard head.
This Krogan's over 1,000 years old. Yeah. It's like he's like end the lifespan Krogan. He's like, shit kid, I've been doing this shit for years.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal, and Tan came down hard.
Damn.
Too hard. So we left. Kesh is alone on that station now.
You think someone might try to hurt Kesh?
Ah, more like she airlocks Spender. Or he tries to stab her in the back, and then she airlocks him. Tan wouldn't listen to me when I told him Spender had a part in the mutiny. I had no proof.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out, and my clan needs to get back on station, without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age, yeah, pretty much.
I'm up for it. Hey, YouTube, we're gonna pause for a second. I'll be back in a flash.